It involved an understudy, the fact that he didn't know his lines, and it was 5 minutes before curtain. I told him I was sick, and then I sprayed my face with water so that I appeared like I had a terrible flu.
I set a lot of booby traps for my mom when I was a kid. So like fishing line wire underneath the door, and she would like walk across it and toys would fall on top of her. Horrible son, yes.
I did the same thing every grade school kid did, and I made scrambled eggs for my parents on April Fool's Day with strings cut up in it.
I told my family that I couldn't come visit them in Washington, D.C. because I wasn't available, and I showed up anyway and knocked on everybody's door by the end of that evening and surprised them.
My brother and I did used to jump out of the bushes and scare the hell out of each other all the time.
I convinced my friend to walk around New York for several hours, where I was secretly hiding them from a surprise birthday party.
It was really mean. I was 14. I played it on my best friend. I'm so sorry, Lacey, and I think I traumatized her for a little bit. My brother and I convinced her that there was somebody trying to break into houses, and his whole thing was that he threw rocks at the back of the window, and I had my brother go outside and throw rocks at the back of the window while I was telling her this story. I'm sorry.
When I was in high school, we were having a fake seance, and I had rigged a couple of alarms to go off in the middle of the seance, so we had contacted, we made contact with spirits.
One time on a family trip, I convinced the members of my family that there was a coyote in one of the rooms, and they came down with pool table billiard sticks. And there was no coyote.
For a period of 9 months, I fooled everyone that I worked with that I was an Australian named Monica. That's not true. That's not true. I'm not Australian. I'm not Monica. I'm just Runner.
When I found a YouTube video, a news broadcast that announced that rockets were being sent over from Russia to blow up the major cities, and we were in Los Angeles at the time, I was able to cast it on the television set and send my family into a panic and deep prayer. You should have seen people praying in there. They thought it was going to hit. It was really good.
My sophomore year in college, there was this really hideous statue out in front of the theater, and our acting teacher, who was Canadian, hated it, and she said so in class. And so one night, me and my two best friends stayed up really late, and we went and we pulled the hand off of the statue, and we wrapped it and put it in a box and gave it to her as a Christmas present.
I recently tricked a regional theater company into thinking I know what I'm doing, and they cast me in Twelfth Night.